This time, I'm going to talk about whole-wide term structure simulation in Python. The whole-wide model is a model of future interest rates. In its most generic formulation, it belongs to the class or non-arbitrage model that are able to fit today's term structure of interest rates. This is a formula for the one-factor whole-wide model. Here, RT is the short-term interest rate at time. Theta T is the mean reversion level of the interest rate at time. Alpha is the mean reversion speed or mean reversion parameter. Sigma is the volatility parameter. DWT is the Wiener process or Brownian motion representing the stochastic component. This stochastic differential equation describes the dynamics of the short-term interest rate, incorporating mean reversion towards theta t, a rate of mean reversion determined by alpha, and a stochastic term represented by sigma dwt. In this video, I'm going to talk about one-factor whole-wide model. And this is the original whole-wide model. And later, there is a model called two-factor whole-wide model. In the one-factor whole-wide model, the term one-factor refers to the single stochastic factor that drives the dynamics of the short-term interest rate. The model assumes that the evolution of the short-term interest rate is influenced by one main stochastic factor, which is typically modeled using a Wiener process or Brownian motion. In this formula, it's this stochastic process DWT. In this formula, there are several parameters like theta t, alpha, and sigma. Please remember, when we talk about one-factor whole-wide model, this one means the single stochastic factor that drives the dynamics of the short-term interest rate. It has nothing to do with number of parameters. The parameter theta t in the one-factor whole-wide model represents the mean reversion level of the short-term interest rate at time t. In practical applications, this parameter is often chosen or calibrated to match the observed or market input term structure of interest rates. The term structure of the interest rates refers to the relationship between interest rates and the time to maturity of financial instruments. It's typically represented by a yield curve, which shows the yield on financial instruments with different maturities. The yield curve is a crucial input for pricing and valuing fixed income securities and interest rate derivatives. In this video, I'm going to calculate the forward rate and then build our whole-wide model. In summary, choosing theta t to fit the input term structure of interest rates is part of the calibration process, where the model is adjusted to match the market data, making it more realistic and useful tool for pricing and risk management in the context of interest rate modeling. In my previous formula for one factor whole white model, sigma is constant. In certain interest rate models, including variation of the whole white model, some people introduce a time-dependent volatility parameter, sigma t. The motivation behind this choice is to capture the observed dynamics of interest rate volatility in financial markets, where the volatility of interest rates may vary over time. Introducing time-dependent volatility can be particularly relevant when modeling interest rates over long periods or during periods of economic uncertainty. It allows a model to adapt to changing market conditions and better captures the observed volatility dynamics in interest rates. Obviously, this time-dependent sigma introduces additional complexity to the model and requires careful calibration to market the data. If you should use constant sigma or time-dependent sigma, depends on what kind of interest rate environment you are in and what's your goal of your analysis. In simpler version of interest rate models, a constant volatility parameter, sigma, is often used for computational simplicity and ease of calibration. In this model, I'm going to use constant sigma for this volatility parameter. Now, let's go through the workflow of this model. First, we are going to import the library and define all those parameters. And then we are going to set up the whole white model. Then we are going to generate random number with this Gaussian random sequence generator. And we are going to generate Gaussian paths. After that, we are going to plot 10 paths from our simulation results. And we are going to compare our simulated variance, which is plotted in red, with the analytical solution for the variance, which will be plotted in blue. And lastly, we are going to compare the mean of the interest rates. One is the simulated mean, which plot in red, and the analytical solution for the mean under the whole white model, which plotted in blue. Okay, now let's go to Python to run our model. First, we are going to import library and define all those parameters. Then we are going to generate this flat forward rate. And then we are going to set up our whole white model here and generate random number. And you can see this one, we use this function to generate our path. And after that, we are going to visualize the simulated path Of course, only for 10 pass for to check our results. And then we are going to compare the variance of the interest rate between the simulated variance and the analytical solution. Lastly, we are going to compare the mean of short interest rates between our simulated mean in red and the analytical solution, which plot in blue. Okay, now let's run our model. You can see this is our simulation results. There's only 10 paths plotted here. And for the variance, you can see this is the mean of our variance. And this blue line is the analytical solution. And for the mean of the short rates, you can see the blue line is the analytical solution, and the red dot is the average of our short rates from our simulation results. I'm going to upload this Python code to my GitHub so you can download it and change the parameter or other settings and run it by yourself. This is how you can do whole white term structure simulation in Python. Please comment, like, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.